Right.
So
yeah.
But because, remind you, I was engaged. I met him 2006. No, I met him January 2007. I was engaged in the year before I knew him. Mm. I was engaged the year before, something like a year or two before.
Oh, so, to somebody else. To somebody else.
To the beta dude.
Okay.
So, and that was a good situation. Me and a dude met in February. No, me and a dude met in November. We were working together. Got engaged on Valentine's Day. November to Valentine's Day, that's not enough time to know somebody. Mm. And so a month after we got engaged, I broke off the engagement. And then a month after that, I broke up with, I broke up our relationship.
Right.
Because I started to know more things about him. And I was like, oh.
So
my kids would have been ugly. And that was.
How do you get to, okay, so you have these kind of, you have these norms that, okay, this is the guy you married. He's got like a business and two cars and a house. Mm-hmm. You have these things that are built into you. You're in this kind of toxic situation. Well, let me back up. One of the reasons why I would say that it's always the guy's fault when the relationship, it's because no matter how crazy she is or not crazy or whatever, if you're not, if you, like for instance, you said that feeling that you have when a dude is ready to go, it's a feeling. You can't tell a alpha woman to be weak, to be less alpha. Like you can't, you know, like you hear your girlfriends will say, oh girl, he's a nice guy. Give him a chance. You might as well, if that's the whole thing with that sharks dating penguins. You the shark. Ah! It's only a matter of time till you taste penguin and bite his head off. So you can only, the podcast's focus was to make guys more confident, to make better versions of men, or have men understand that being the best version of themselves is where the confidence comes. You can't tell a strong woman to be weaker. She's just never going to respect this guy because she knows.
The dude I was engaged to was very weak and I wanted no parts of it. Right. Because I was making all the, I mean, I'm only fresh out of college. I'm making all the decisions, you know, all this other, there's so many other things that are wrong, you know, at home and all his life and all this other shit. And my kids would have been ugly. So I was like, I gotta get out of this. But like with him, when it comes to just me being the type of person that I am, it's like I was over at his house one time. He had a bunch of his friends there. And, I got up to get him. I was getting up to get something to drink. So I asked him if he wanted something to drink. And then I asked his friends if they wanted something to drink. Right. And I'm going to the kitchen and I hear his homeboy say, yo, how you get her to do that? He's like, what are you talking about? He's like, my girl don't get up. She don't ask my homeboys if they want anything. He said, that's just how she is. I don't make her do that. Right. Like when the recession hit in 2008, he went from making, you know.
Now this is not the beta dude. This the other dude.
No, this is the mechanic dude. So
right, okay.
And so
now, did you do that to the beta dude? Like, if he had his friends, would you like everybody? Is that just the southern thing, or were you like?
I mean, he lived at his mother's house, so I couldn't do any of that. That lady was mad anytime I was in her fucking kitchen.
Okay.
Which is also some real old school southern shit, but like. You know, when he...
The beta dude, was he black or white, out of curiosity?
He was black. Most of my long-term relationships have been black because, like, one of my best relationships that... I mean, just to finish, like, wrapping up with him, it's just like, you know, I was very... He lied to me a lot because I would want to go out. He would say yes in my presence. And then when we weren't around each other, the story would change. And eventually we got to the point where it was just like, well, I really didn't, like, if you didn't want to do it in the first place, if you had no intention of doing it, you should have just told me no in person instead of not dealing with my emotions at the time. Cause now you got me mad because you lied to me, as opposed to I'm not mad. He's like, well, I was like, it's not about going out. It's that you lied. Mm. Give a fuck about going to a movie with your monkey ass. It's not the point. You lied to me. And so, I mean, and he's married now to some girl who's built like a can of soup, but it's it was never a good relationship because he wanted total control. I just wanted him to tell me the truth and respect me to a certain point. But he didn't want to do that because he wanted things to go only his way.
Young Man School 202. Better hear what I've got to say because you won't get it again.
I'm not an alpha male. I'm not a beta male either. I'm just a better man. Better man. Better man. Put your happiness first, because if you don't, they won't.